How you handling all this so far?
Hasn't really sunk in, Theo.
Yeah. It's gonna hurt like hell when it does. My Janie died. This is no good. 6 months. Well, my kids are all grown up. I had that luxury. You got domestic responsibilities.
Domestic responsibilities?
Yeah. You gotta take care of my daughter and those little girls. That's gotta be your first priority now.
Well, you figured that might have slipped my mind, huh, Theo?
Just needed to be said, that's all.
I know what it looks like. The forgetfulness, the anger, mood swings. I know how terrible...
You know nothing. Jonas Stern does not have dementia.
Mr. Stern, you're facing jail time.
I know that.
Your condition is your defense. This isn't a DUI.
There is no condition. I'll be damned if I'm going to have people think that Jonas Stern is losing his mind.
There are three people who know what you know. One is my doctor, the second one is me, and the third is now covered by attorney-client privilege. And as your client, I am ordering you not to breathe a word of this. Not in my defense, not to anyone, do you understand? Do you understand?
I understand.
But if launched, those missiles from Cuba would kill a lot of Americans. The very presence of those missiles gives the Soviets first strike capability. Those missiles make a nuclear exchange more likely. And that is why I'm being such a pain in the ass about destroying them and destroying them immediately. Given your own statements about Cuba, I think a blockade or a bunch of political talk be considered by a lot of our friends and neutrals as a pretty weak response. I suspect that many of our own citizens might feel the same way. You're in a pretty bad fix, Mr. President.
What did you say?
You're in a pretty bad fix.
Well, maybe you haven't noticed you're in it with me.
Those goddamn Kennedys are gonna destroy this country if we don't do something about this. You know how I used to tell you about Van Buren scoring that touchdown back in 48? Yeah, I know. That touchdown got me through 30 years at that factory. Got me through all those times your mother being sick. When I told you not to get your hopes up, didn't mean that I wasn't.
I've had a tail on him for days. He was there.
I can't believe it.
Didn't I tell you? Someday that son of a bitch would turn on you.
All right, bitch, you told me, but I can't believe that.
Well, Johnny, you better believe it. Listen, I think we got to get Milano to handle
this. No, I want Milano out of it.
Johnny, do you know what's going to come out? All the stuff about the jukeboxes, the loans, everything. They're going to pin a bribe on you.
Yes, I never took nothing in my life, and you know that.
They're going to ruin you, and they're going to ruin us, and they're going to ruin this union.
Shut up! Nobody's going to ruin the union!
That camp was unlike anything I'd ever experienced. Too many POWs in too small a space. You could smell it from a mile off. The officers were kept in bamboo pens and given one meal a day. The enlisted men were fed scraps and were shackled to tree trunks. After about a week, they didn't have any feeling left in their limbs. They couldn't sleep. If they did, the rats would gnaw them to the bone. Escape was the only option.
In a contemporary play, somebody would say, "Hey, you, go over there, get that thing and bring it back to me." That would be the line. Shakespeare says it, be Mercury. Set feathers to thy heels and fly like thought from them to me again.
The king is weak and sickly, and his physicians fear him mightily.
Oh, by St. John, that news is bad indeed. Oh, he hath kept an evil diet long.
You should... I want you to trade me, Gabe. George said if I wanted out, I could get out.
Oh, I don't think I can do that.
I think you can. I mean, when I signed my contract, George said specifically if I wanted out, he would accommodate me.
Well, I don't think that's specifically in your contract, is it?
Gabe, listen to me, all right? I don't mean you any disrespect. You put together a hell of a ball club here, but I'm just not right for it. That's clear. I haven't been since day one.
You know, Reggie, Branch Rickey used to say, don't look at the hole in the donut. Look at the donut as a whole.
What the hell are you talking about? Is that your answer? Donuts?
Yeah, pretty much.